Horrid Henry's stink bomb. Da, da, da.
I hate you, Margaret, shrieked Sour Susan. She stumbled out of the secret club tent.
I hate you too, shrieked Moody Margaret.
Sour Susan stuck out her tongue. Moody Margaret stuck out hers back.
I quit, yelled Susan.
You can't quit.
You're fired, yelled Margaret.
You can't fire me because I quit, said Susan.
I fired you first,
said Margaret. And I'm changing the password.
Go ahead, see if I care. I don't want to be in the secret club anymore, said Susan sourly.
Good, because we don't want you.
Moody Margaret flounced back inside the secret club tent. Sour Susan stalked off. Free at last. Susan was sick and tired of her ex-best friend, Bossy Boots Margaret, blaming her for the disastrous raid on the Purple Hand Fort when it was all Margaret's fault was bad enough. But then to ask stupid Linda to join the secret club without even telling her. Susan hated Linda even more than she hated Margaret. Linda hadn't invited Susan to her sleepover party. And she was a copycat. But Margaret didn't care. Today she'd made Linda chief spy. Well, Susan had had enough. Margaret had been mean to her once too often. Susan heard gales of laughter from inside the club tent. So they were laughing. Were they? Laughing at her, no doubt. Well, she'd show them. She knew all about Margaret's top secret plans. And she knew someone who would be very interested in that information.
Halt! Password?
So many toads, said Perfect Peter. He waited outside Henry's Purple Hand Fort.
Wrong,
said Horrid Henry.
What's the new one then?
Said Perfect Peter.
I'm not telling you, said Henry. You're fired, remember?
Perfect Peter did remember. He had hoped Henry had forgotten.
Can't I join again, Henry? Asked Peter.
No way, said Horrid Henry.
Please,
said Perfect Peter.
No,
said Horrid Henry.
Ralph's taken over your duties.
Rude Ralph poked his head through the branches of Henry's lair.
No babies allowed, said Rude Ralph. We don't want you here, Peter,
said Horrid Henry.
Get lost! Perfect Peter burst into tears.
Cry baby, jeered Horrid Henry.
Cry baby,
jeered Rude Ralph.
That did it.
Mum!
Wailed Perfect Peter. He ran towards the house.
Henry won't let me play, and he called me a crybaby.
Stop being horrid, Henry,
shouted Mum. Peter waited. Mum didn't say anything else. Perfect Peter started to wail louder.
Mum! Henry's being mean to me.
Leave Peter alone, Henry,
shouted Mum. She came out of the house. Her hands were covered in dough.
Henry, if you don't stop!
Mum looked around.
Where's Henry?
In his fort, snivelled Peter.
I thought you said he was being mean to you, said Mum.
He was,
wailed Peter.
Just keep away from him,
said Mum. She went back into the house. Perfect Peter was outraged.
Was that it? Why hadn't she punished Henry? Henry had been so horrid he deserved to go to prison for a year.
2 years!
And just get a crust of bread a week!
And Brussels sprouts. Ha! That would serve Henry right. But until Henry went to prison, how could Peter pay him back? And then Peter knew exactly what he could do. He checked carefully to see what no one was watching. Then he sneaked over the garden wall and headed for the secret club tent. He isn't, said Margaret.
She wouldn't, said Henry.
He's planning to swap our lemonade for a dungeon drink, said Margaret.
Yes, said Peter.
She's planned to stink bomb the purple hand fort, said Henry.
Yes, said Susan.
How dare she, said Henry.
How dare he, said Margaret.
I'll easily put a stop to that.
Linda,
she barked, hide the lemonade. Linda yawned.
Hide it yourself, she said.
I'm tired.
Margaret glared at her, then hid the jug under a box.
Ha ha! Won't Henry be shocked when he sneaks over and there are no drinks to spike?
Gloated Margaret. Peter, you're a hero. I award you the triple star, the highest honour the secret club can bestow.
Ooh, thanks, said Peter. It was nice being appreciated for a change.
So from now on, said Moody Margaret, you're working for me.
Okay, said the traitor.
Horrid Henry rubbed his hands. This was fantastic. At last he had a spy in his enemy's camp. He'd easily defend himself against that stupid stink bomb.
Margaret would only let it off when he was in the fort. His sentry would be on the lookout armed with a goo shooter. When Margaret tried to sneak in with her stink bomb, kapow.
Hang on a sec, said Horrid Henry. Why should I trust you?
Because Margaret is mean and horrible and I hate her, said Susan.
So from now on, said Horrid Henry, you're working for me. Susan wasn't sure she liked the sound of that. Then she remembered Margaret's mean cackle.
Okay, said the traitor.
Peter sneaked back into his garden and collided with someone.
Ouch, said Peter.
Susan. They glared at each other suspiciously.
What were you doing at Margaret's? Said Susan.
Nothing,
said Peter.
What were you doing at my house?
Nothing, said Susan.
Peter walked towards Henry's fort, whistling. Susan walked towards Margaret's tent, whistling.
Well,
if Susan was spying on Henry for Margaret, Peter certainly wasn't going to warn him. Serve Henry right.
Well, if Peter was spying on Margaret for Henry, Susan certainly wasn't going to warn her. Serve Margaret right.
Dungeon drinks,
eh?
Margaret liked that idea much better than her stink bomb plot.
I've changed my mind about the stink bomb, said Margaret. I'm going to swap his drinks for dungeon drink stinkers instead.
Good idea, said Lazy Linda.
Less work.
Stink bomb, eh? Henry liked that much better than his dungeon drink pot. Why hadn't he thought of that himself?
I've changed my mind about the dungeon drink, said Henry. I'm going to stink bomb her instead.
Yeah, said Rudolph.
When?
Now, said Horrid Henry.
Come on, let's go to my room.
Horrid Henry opened his stinky stink bombs kit. He brought it with Grandma.
Mum would never have let him buy it, but because Grandma had given him the money, Mum couldn't do anything about it.
Ha ha ha.
Now, which pong would he pick? He looked at the test tubes filled with powder and read the gruesome labels. Bad breath, dog poo, rotten eggs, smelly socks, dead fish,
sewer stench.
I'd go for dead fish, said Ralph.
That's the worst,
Henry considered. How about we mix dead fish and rotten eggs?
Yeah, said Horrid Rude Ralph.
Slowly. Carefully,
her
Horrid Henry measured out a teaspoon of dead fish powder and a teaspoon of rotten egg powder into the special pouch. Slowly, carefully, Rude Ralph poured out 150 milliliters of secret stink bomb liquid into the bottle and capped it tightly. All they had to do was to add the powder to the bottle outside the secret club and run! Ready, said Horrid Henry.
Ready,
said Rude Ralph. Whatever you do, said Horrid Henry, don't spill it. So you've come crawling back, said Moody Margaret. I knew you would. No, said Sir Susan. I just happened to be passing. She looked around the secret club tent. Where's Linda? Margaret scowled.
Gone.
Gone for today or gone forever, said Susan.
Forever, said Margaret savagely.
I don't even want to see that lazy lump again. Margaret and Susan looked at each other. Susan tapped her foot. Margaret hummed.
Well,
I said Margaret.
Well, what? Said Susan.
Are you rejoining the secret club as chief spy or aren't you?
I might, said Susan,
and I might not.
Suit yourself,
said Margaret. I'll call Gorinda and ask her to join instead.
Okay, said Susan quickly. I'll join.
Should she mention her visit to Henry?
Better not.
After all, what Margaret didn't know wouldn't hurt her. Now, about my stink bomb plot, began Margaret. I decided something shattered on the ground inside the tent. A ghastly, gruesome, grisly stinky stench filled the air. Screamed Margaret, gagging.
It's a stink bomb!
Help! Shrieked Sour Susan. Stink bomb! Help! Help! Victory! Horrid Henry and Rude Ralph ran back to the Purple Hand Fort and rolled round the floor laughing and shrieking. What a triumph! Margaret and Susan screaming. Margaret's mum screaming. Margaret's dad screaming. And the stink! Wow! Horrid Henry had never smelled anything so awful in his life. This called for a celebration. Horrid Henry offered Ralph a fistful of sweets and poured out two glasses of fizzy whiz drinks.
Cheers, said Henry.
Cheers, said Ralph.
They drank.
Ah! Oh, what?
Choked Rude Ralph. Yelped Horrid Henry, gagging and spitting.
We've been dungeon drained.
And then Horrid Henry heard a horrible sound. Moody Margaret and Sour Susan were outside the Purple Hand Fort, chanting a victory chant. Na 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 na.